life. He went in there, he wanted to talk to the ladies. He's just that kind of a brash guy. He thinks his mouth is just as big as his muscles. He has no fear.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying if
he's like everybody else in the NWO. They have no fear when they're all together, but this man was doing this on his own, apparently, by himself.
Well, he's...
That's a different story.
He's got an eye for the ladies. Well, nothing wrong with that.
Well, I don't think there's anything wrong with that either, but he needs to leave the girl alone. I mean...
Well, she's told him, I don't know how many times, she isn't interested, but he just can't take no for an answer. You gotta nag. That's what you gotta do.
Yeah,
that's
but you
what
can't
works.
Barge into the locker room.
Well, if he knocked, they wouldn't let him in. I'm not saying he's right, I'm saying...
No, you're saying he's right, and you're wrong, and so is he. End of story.
Oh.
Hopefully it's a story we do not have to follow much longer. All right. Brian Adams and Horace reluctantly are out, and the World Tag Team Tournament is off and running. Kidman and Chavo Jr., the Cruiserweight champ. Chavo Guerrero Jr., the team.
It's like Kidman. It's like Chavo's got a new horse. Oh, that's Kidman.
And that's not funny. So here we go for the tournament. And it's good. The tournament's starting, and we see no members of the Wolfpack here. At least they, according to that telegram that Vincent received, that they are still stuck in Tampa, Florida somewhere. But then we saw Ric Flair, the Horseman, get out of that NWO limousine. So I don't know if they're really stuck in Tampa or if maybe it's been another Horseman attack to keep them out.
You know, if you think of it, they came in that NWO limousine with the license plate in red and black. Where are the members that were supposed to be in that car? Maybe they're in some alley unconscious right now.
And Ric Flair starts the tournament here tonight. Maybe knowing that they're not going to be here to disrupt the tournament. Very interesting, wouldn't you think, Mike?
I think that makes a lot of sense. Like you say, with Hogan, Hall, and Nash in absentia this evening at Thunder. Not here, they're absent.
Okay.
From
supper.
Thunder. Okay. Absentia, Indiana. Vincent has decided to take over the reins, so to speak, sending Brian Adams and Horace out in this tag team tournament match.
That seems to be working good for the black and white. Horace has come a long way.
And again, we understand that Chavo Guerrero Jr. convinced Kidman to be his tag team partner in the tournament. Opportunity here for Kidman to add some tag team gold to his WCW World Cruiserweight Championship belt.
Whoa!
Big peel out of the corner of the neutral corner by Horace Hogan.
H-bomb, it says there.
Talented guy, this Horace Hogan, and I would think, and this is just on the surface here, knowing that right hand there by Horace Hogan, knowing that Nash and Hall and the Wolfpack did not want this tournament to take place in a great move, that Horace would be very reluctant even to get into this thing. Anybody in the NWO would be, but here they are. And I think it's only right. Remember, as Flair said, the final match will be held in Super Brawl. Kidman with superior balance. Once again, tag is made. Here comes Chavo Jr. in a drop toe hold to start things.
Textbook drop toe hold, and that's the way to take the big man down to the canvas.
Well, like I said earlier, it's going to be size and strength against speed and finesse. So far, the speed's working out pretty good. Except for now.
Yeah, took a plummet on the outside. And the big man, Brian Adams, down low with Vincent.
And he is a big man, this Adams.
You know, we tried to read in some possibilities why Vincent took off the white and black and was donning the red. And he just, when they asked him about it, he kind of just shook it off, didn't he, in the ring. He wouldn't elaborate for his own teammates.
Well, there's so much trouble going on that you can see they're all on different pages. They don't understand each other. They're not letting each other talk. They're not sitting down as a group and thinking things out. They're lost.
Chavo tries a crossbody, but too much man on the other end.
Watch this.
From behind. That'll work. Great double team. One, two, and he got a two count on Brian Adams. How about that? And an arm drag takedown.
Yeah, very smart move by Kidman. Drop kicking his own tag partner, Chavo Jr., in the back. And the weight propelled Chavo Jr. over for a two count onto Brian Adams. We've talked about the power and strength advantage that Adams and Horace have.
Oh, tag was made.
Good move. Good tag team wrestling.
One, two, no.
One other thing to take into account is the experience. As far as I know, it's the first time that Kidman and Chavo Jr. have been a tag team.
And a
tilt the world backbreaker.
Maybe the last.
I don't know if there is some sort of social status within the ranks of the NWO or not, but if you want to start a group to dominate pro wrestling, I would think a guy like Brian Adams should be one of your charter members. He is just so talented and so big and strong.
And he's been there. He knows his way around the ring.
One, two, and he makes a Chris Jericho-type cover, but to no avail. All right, I'm told we got to take a commercial break.
Well, someone told me.
Well, they don't need to tell you. The tape machine's rolling, and we'll have more live on Thunder after this.
They just told me. We're back.
Will they tell you that?
Mm-hmm. They did. All right, welcome back, fans, to Thunder here on TBS. Tony Schiavone, you know the brain, and the professor Mike today. And here goes Kidman, the Cruiserweight champ, using that speed we talked about that he needed to use to be successful in this World Tag Team Tournament match.
Now the fresh man hits the ring. Tag into Chavo Jr. Full leg extension that time by Horace. Almost took the head of Chavo Jr. off. Oh, he just nailed him. Tag into Brian Adams. And Adams connects with the leg drop. Just now toying with Chavo. And again.
If they were smart, the NWO, they would take Kidman or Chavo, who's ever in the ring, keep him in the corner. Fast tags in and out. And use their size, their strength, and their girth to keep that man grounded. And just pulverize and pummel and beat and just stomp. And that's the way to win the match.
Thank you there, Coach. Into the corner now. Well, Ric Flair revamped this tournament and restarted the tournament. He also added something that I don't think has ever been done, especially here in WCW. He made it a double elimination tournament, which means that you can lose a match but stay in it. But you lose two, of course, and you're out. So it's not really a sudden death type matchup for either team here, but they certainly would like to get the winner's bracket. First and foremost, hit a belly to back and a good power move by Chavo.
I think that's a good call by the new president of WCW, Ric Flair. You know, in case there was a fluke or something like that, that team is not going to be eliminated. They have to lose twice before they're taken out of the bracket.
We got a fight on the floor with Vincent and Kidman.
Oh, almost had the tag.
Chavo in. Look at that leaping ability. Leg spring by Chavo. Drop kick.
He should have tagged out. He had the opportunity.
Horace gets a bulldog from Chavo, who needs to get to Kidman for a tag. Can he get there? Tag to Horace. And here comes the WCW Cruiserweight champ, Kidman. In the ropes. He's up on top. Boom! What a move! But Horace Hogan's in. Kidman.
Horace Hogan's out.
Double drop kick. Other side now. What a team. Look at him back to back. He's got a slapjack in his hand.
He's got that slapjack. And who's out?
He hit Kidman.
Chavo just jumped out of the way. And look, Vincent hit Kidman in the back of the head.
Stevie, the referee all through of that. One, two, three, NWO's going to win it.
He's out cold.
They were back to back.
You know, they were doing good there.
Yes, they were.
They were working as a team good. They were standing back to back. They were throwing flying drop kicks.
But then Stevie Ray appeared, got the referee's attention.
Here's a fight cover. And this tonight, so be ready for it.
Did we really have to stop talking to Mr. Matt?
What you doing, my slapjack?
Yeah, he's got a slapjack. Kidman knows all about it. At least when it comes to, he will. Yeah, watch the back of the head. Here it is again.
See, Vincent right there takes off that slapjack, sneaks into the ring, comes up from behind on Kidman, lights out.